A US spy plane video has been leaked, revealing a sighting of a UFO shaped like a rubber duck flying at incredible speeds in Arizona and leaving most experts puzzled. What could it be? Is it an alien aircraft? An alien drone? And why so often in the area of Arizona?
Section 51.
Hi everyone, what's up guys, DOZgeek here with Section 51. Big thanks again for your support to the channel. As always, first, please hit that like button and share this new video right now to keep supporting Section 51. And don't forget, of course, to watch this video until the end. For your information, I will be on the YouTube channel Alien Addict tomorrow to talk during a live stream about our last episode with History Channel, and the proof is out there. And now, if you are ready, let's start right now. A new leaked video reveals what seems to be a rubber duck-shaped UFO caught on camera by accident by a US reconnaissance plane in November 2019. According to the video data, the UFO, or UAP, is said to have hit speeds of 200 miles per hour as it was tracked for 40 minutes. For a few days now, this strange UFO sighting in the southwestern region of the United States, in Arizona, is indeed driving the internet quackers, with the footage exposing the shape of the UFO to be similar to that of a bathtub toy. The footage dates back to November 23, 2019. It was taken at roughly 9 p.m. when a RC-26 surveillance aircraft flown by the Department of Homeland Security, the DHS, tracked the UFO for around 40 minutes. However, the recording has only recently been made public. Footage begins with the plane's crew surveying the landscape using their thermal optics system, known as FLIR, as they were said to be on a reconnaissance mission. The DHS agents had originally been tracking down drug smugglers located in Tucson, Arizona, using a thermal optics system called FLIR. While the first 20 minutes of the footage shows the reconnaissance mission going ahead as normal, with the plane's crew simply observing the landscape, the rubber duck UFO then suddenly comes racing into the frame. The shape, estimated to be around 6 feet long, hurtles over the landscape and appears to change before speed and direction as it moves. For around 40 minutes, the aircraft's FLIR camera operator tracks the object during the encounter not far from the US's southern border with Mexico. The object appears to be moving between 90 and 200 miles per hour according to the data available in the video. It's moving very fast, and it seems to travel incredible distances. After just under an hour, the video cuts off with the rubber duck still in view. It is unclear what the object in the video is, and for now the phenomena remains unexplainable. The Department of Homeland Security has not been able to identify the object, but no doubt that the video footage is still under analysis by experts. And it is also unclear if the strange shape is one object or two flying alongside each other. Some have speculated the object could be a cluster of balloons, or potentially a modified drone. According to Andy, who posted the footage on YouTube via NYUAP discussion, he knew immediately that the footage was something of value.
The object is emitting zero heat, yet accelerates and decelerates throughout the footage. The change in speed and direction is evident by the terrain as it changes while the object is being tracked, and also the speed can be seen in the upper right-hand side of the FLIR info. The object can also be seen rotating as it flies. Birds, balloons, drones, and all other conventional explanation has been ruled out until Mick West gets a hold of this and claims the object is nothing more than a frisbee thrown by the world's strongest man. Mick West himself.
I don't know why, but that last sentence makes me smile. Moreover, the footage was confirmed as being real and legitimate footage from the DHS by Luis Elizondo, a former insider from the Pentagon. Mr. Elizondo, however, said while the object is not identified, he believes it could be a cluster of balloons. But this is a first reaction, and further analysis is needed before making more conclusions. We all know now that the Pentagon UFO report confirmed there have been numerous unexplained encounters between the US military and UFOs. 144 unexplained UFO encounters with the military, including tic-tac-shaped UFOs buzzing US warships and warplanes, and it did not rule out the possibility of aliens. And in one of the most infamous encounters, a former US launch officer, Captain Robert Salas, claims the objects shut down nuclear missiles. However, FLIR expert Dave Falk also weighed in on the video and confirmed he believes the object remains unexplained. He even said he was at a complete loss as to what this could be. According to him, it is likely not to be a plane, balloon or drone. I also invite you to watch his YouTube video, it's very informative. Falk compared FLIR footage of balloons, drones and birds to the video as none of them appears to match up with the object seen in the video. The footage has chilling echoes of the infamous 2013 Aguadilla UAP footage, which was described by scientists as the most compelling UFO ever caught on camera. In the previous video about the UFO caught on camera by ISS, thanks to the reactions of some viewers and with their help, I finally had to admit that I was fooled by the video footage of Rafael Navarro Ferrari, which seems to be a hoax. In fact, what seems to be a UFO mothership could have been a misinterpretation of a part of the ISS appearing on the top of the screen. We can see the same V shape. Moreover, the entire image seems to have been cut on the top in order to hide this part of the ISS, which clearly means that it was intended to confuse this part of the structure with an alien UFO. Then the video was displayed on a big TV screen and filmed by smartphone in order to hide more easily the hoax process. So I was wrong thinking that it could be a UFO, but it was still interesting to ask questions and to study all the different aspects around this case. Isn't that research, after all? No one is perfect. Everybody can make mistakes. And we can learn from our mistakes. In any process of thinking, it is important not to close doors. Not like most debunkers or fact-checkers who show incredible arrogance by pretending to know everything and trying to impose their vision of things at all costs. Beware of those who never make mistakes, because they are false prophets. But that still doesn't answer one of my questions concerning this video. Why are we seeing in this video so many luminous spheres ascending from Earth to space? How do we explain it? Here with Section 51, I will never try to impose you my own vision. You are always free to follow or not my thoughts, my feelings, with respect for each. I like to explore different possibilities and, as was saying Greek philosopher Socrates, I also know that I know nothing. We are dealing with such vast subjects and so full of unanswered questions that we must remain humble. We are just trying to do our part of the work in the field of UFOs on this channel. It's a small part, yes, but it's full of small cumulative parts that will eventually maybe complete the immense puzzle of truth. To continue to turn a blind eye and remain in denial with the subject of UFOs equals to lack intellectual honesty. In this last case, the case of the rubber duck-shaped UFO, we are still beginning to have several expert opinions, which gradually reduces the possibilities of being a cluster of balloons. But anything is possible until we have more information. But this is not a single UFO sighting. Apparently, several UFO sightings were reported in the same area. This one is another example, another video footage received from the DHS 4 months back. It was filmed in Tohono O'odham Indian Reserve in Arizona. I will put the link in the description below. According to NYUAP discussion, the object seen in the rubber duck footage is the same object seen in this footage, the La Bruja footage recorded in 2020. Both objects are emitting no heat and are roughly the same size. This footage, however, shows that this cannot be a drone due to the fact that it flies over a herd of cattle in the middle of the night without spooking a single one. The object also slows down at one point and is seen flying vertically, not horizontally. Hence the Spanish name La Bruja, which translates to the witch. The reason it was given that name is because for many years now, Mexicans have had multiple sightings, going back to the early 90s, of a humanoid-type object seen flying low near mountains in different parts of Mexico. It resembles a witch riding a broom. Locals fear it and believe it is a bad omen. Upon closer inspection of La Bruja, you will also see that it has a second appendage, just like rubber duck, but it shows at the bottom of the object. You can also see that there is a space between the smaller part and the larger part, just like rubber duck. The object also rotates at certain points, just like rubber duck. It also looks to emit light directly beneath it, just like rubber duck does as it passes certain hills. So what could it be? Is it an alien aircraft? An alien drone with unknown technology? And why so often in the area of Arizona? Is it connected to black projects allegedly developed in Area 51 or in Area 52? Yet another incredible infrared video showing a UFO and raising more and more questions. One more proof that our planet is regularly visited by unknown entities. Maybe one day, we will have the chance to watch the video. The big one that will bring us the answers. However, I would be curious to see the end of this one to know how it ended. I hope you enjoyed this video. Section 51 is on social networks, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Don't forget to hit that like button and that bell button too. Don't forget to share the video and to subscribe to Section 51. You can also visit our Spreadshirt shop to get a beautiful accessory Section 51. This was DOZgeek with Section 51. I'll be back really soon. Meanwhile, see you tomorrow on Alien Addict channel for a new live stream at 9 PM UK time. Open your eyes, watch the sky, live long and prosper.